Hi everyone, Letty here. Today I'm going to share with you a crafty collab that I'm doing with my friend Bitty Penny. It's going to be an easy card hack using Hobby Lobby ephemera that we both picked up. So welcome back everyone. Today I'm going to just do a quick little collab with my friend Bitty Penny, who's Toby here on YouTube. We picked up this same pack of ephemera at Hobby Lobby. It comes with 100 pieces. It's really fun. Lots of florals and butterflies. We live really close together, so we sometimes go to Hobby Lobby. This pack comes with 100 pieces. It's two each of 50 designs. So it was $4.99. I think it was on sale. Paper Studio was 40% off, so we paid $2.99 for that. I'm also going to be doing, as part of my crafty goals, I'm going to be smashing this pad, which was and many more. I just did a Smash Our Stash video where I show you everything that I made with that, so I'll link that at the end. I'm also bringing in the October 2021 sheetload of cards by Call Me Crafty Al. Alicia usually puts out a new template every month. I'll link her video down below so you can check it out. She only asks that you subscribe to her channel to get it for free. So I'm also bringing in a stamp by Catherine Pooler. It's Look Who's Talking Sentiments. I picked it up from Not Too Shabby. And then I have already made all of my card bases off camera. Again, I used the paper from that paper pad as part of a smash. And then what we're going to be doing is we are going to be doing a little hack. Each one of us will show a hack. You see there, I already have glued the extras into the inside of the cards, my little scraps. I did have some scrap strips, so I went ahead and made a couple of extra card bases that were not part of the sheet load, just with those scraps. So I had 15 A2 size cards ready to go. Now, my hack is that I like to layer up white die cut pieces that have sentiments on them and then add ephemera or stickers or anything else to embellish around or outside of that. And so I feel like this white die cut really does kind of anchor everything down and takes up a lot of kind of real estate on the card, that it makes it very easy to decorate and to make a ton of cards. So you see here, this is what it would look like. You see here how it automatically changes the look of the card just by putting this white die cut on there. And then what I'll do is I'll add that ephemera right on top, and it will basically finish out the card for us. And the neat thing about this is you can do a ton of them really, really fast without a whole bunch of like thought to it, because you've already kind of die cut all your images and you're just gonna layer up the ephemera. So what I'm showing you here is that you actually could just lay up the ephemera right on top of the card front and it would look gorgeous. However, my little hack, or I don't even know if it's a hack, just one little techniques that I like to do all the time, is that if you add that little white die cut on the bottom, it just really anchors everything down and it gives you a spot to put your sentiment. I really like the look of crisp black, which is my Memento Tuxedo black, I think, ink on white cardstock. And so I'm just going through, you saw there, I had several different versions of my stitched scalloped die cut, either circles or ovals. I did put my little sentiment in different places. I positioned it in different areas of the circle or the die cut. So I have my cards. I'm gonna go off camera and I'm gonna glue all of those white die cuts down to my cards. So I already have all of my die cuts on top of my cards. They're already glued down. You see there the positioning of the Happy Birthday stamp set, which is that Catherine Pooler stamp set. I love her fonts. I have it in all different areas. And my goal for my next step is that I'm gonna go through and add all of the ephemera to all of the fronts of the cards. So it'll be super, super fun. Now, before I do so, I wanted to show you this. This is the glue that Toby, who is Bitty Penny, uses all the time. I wanted to show you. These two bottles cost about the same amount. So this is about $11 and some cents for this big bottle. What I did was I cleaned out an old Barely Arts glue bottle, really good, and then I went ahead and filled it up with the Line Co. glue. I do have an Amazon link that I'll link down below. So far, I've been liking it. So I have already gone through, I've added all the ephemera on my cards. Again, this was from the And Many More by Pink Paisley paper pad. And then I did use 50 of the 100 pieces. So you see here, I still have a ton. And this is something that is at Hobby Lobby right now. So if this is something that you want, again, it was $2.99 because Paper Studio was 40% off. I did also bring in the pink and main crystal clear enamel dots. I used half of them. I wasn't too excited about these. They kept falling off, but I went ahead and used them. They were in my stash. And then, of course, that sheet load as well. And I'll link Alicia's channel down in the description box below so you can check it out in case you haven't had a sheet load. So here are my finished cards. I really like the look of these. I really like that white crisp under all of the color from the ephemera. You can see here, and again, this is a pack of ephemera that's currently at Hobby Lobby right now. So if this is something that you want to try out, you absolutely can go, or if you just think the ephemera is beautiful, go to Hobby Lobby, pick it up. I would wait until they have their Hobby Lobby, like the Paper Studio sale that's 40% off. They used to do 50%, but now it's 40%. You can pick it up at $2.99 for the pack, which I think is a phenomenal deal because you get 100 pieces. It's 50 different designs. You get two of each. That totals your 100. And again, I only use 50 to make all of these 15 A2 size cards as part of my paper pad smash project. I used up that ephemera from Hobby Lobby. Again, as part of my little crafty collab with Betty Penny, make sure you check out her video. I will link it down below, but also check out her channel so you can see what hack she wanted to share today using the same ephemera. Happy crafting!